Welcome to the online lecture series of refrigeration and air conditioning. Here is Professor Lakshman Mane. This is a video session on desirable properties of refrigerants. In this session, you will be able to explain desirable properties of primary refrigerant and secondary refrigerant. Desirable properties of primary refrigerant are classified into four main categories as thermodynamic properties, physical properties, safe working properties, and other properties. Thermodynamic property of refrigerant include boiling point. It is a temperature at which liquid refrigerant at evaporator converted into vapor by absorbing heat from the space to be cooled. As boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius, it is not possible to get evaporated by picking or carrying heat from the space to be cooled. Hence, refrigerant R134a having boiling point minus 26.3 degree Celsius is used in a domestic refrigerator in order to pick heat from the evaporator. So, boiling point of refrigerant should be low. High boiling point of refrigerant reduces capacity of the system. Freezing point is a temperature at which working substance is getting solidified. As freezing temperature of water is 0 degree Celsius, if it is used in a vapor compression refrigeration system, then after expansion valve, as temperature goes below 0 degree Celsius, then it will get solidified and circulation of refrigerant will not be possible in a cooling coil. Hence, freezing point of the refrigerant should be below operating evaporator temperature, means it should be low. So, refrigerant R134a having freezing point minus 103.3 degree Celsius is used in a domestic refrigerator. In evaporator, pressure applied by vapor should be positive, means above atmosphere, in order to avoid the entry of air and moisture inside the cooling coil. Critical temperature is a temperature below which it is not possible to condensate or liquefy the refrigerant. Hence, critical temperature of the refrigerant should be higher than the condenser temperature. Latent heat of evaporation of refrigerant is amount of heat in a kilojoule absorbed by the refrigerant of 1 kilogram from the space to be cooled. So it should be high for greater refrigerating effect per kg of refrigerant. Physical properties of the refrigerants are specific volume. It is volume in meter cube of 1 kg refrigerant, which should be low in order to reduce the size of compressor. Hence, reciprocating compressors are used with low specific volume. In case of high specific volume, centrifugal compressors are used. Specific heat is a heat carrying capacity of the refrigerant of 1 kilogram with temperature rise of 1 degree Celsius, heat 1 kilojoule. So, specific heat of refrigerant for vapor should be high for more refrigerating effect per kg, and it should be low for liquid refrigerant state. Thermal conductivity is the ability of refrigerant to carry or convey heat from the evaporator. So, thermal conductivity of refrigerant means heat carrying capacity or heat absorbing ability of refrigerant from the air should be high in both states, means vapor and liquid. Viscosity is a resistance offered by a refrigerant fluid to its flow. So, when refrigerant is having low viscosity, it is easy to move or handle, but when the refrigerant is more viscous, then it is difficult to move. It will take more effort. So, in both states of refrigerant, means liquid and vapor, viscosity of refrigerant should be low in order to reduce compression power taken by the compressor. Safe working properties of refrigerants. Flammability. Refrigerant should be non-flammable. Normally, hydrocarbons such as methane, ethane, propane, and butane are highly flammable. Hence, these should be used in a refrigeration system with utmost care. Toxicity. Toxic nature of gas refrigerant is harmful to the human life. Hence, refrigerant should be non-toxic in a nature. Refrigerants R114 and sulfur dioxide are most toxic. Hence, these are not used in domestic refrigeration systems. Action of refrigerant with oil are having three categories: immiscible, miscible, and partial miscible. Oil used in a compressor for lubrication purpose is used along with refrigerant. So, in case of immiscible, refrigerant R134a, ammonia, and carbon dioxide are immiscible refrigerants in which oil separator is installed in discharge line, means after compressor, in order to separate the lubricant oil, in order to avoid to pass it to the condenser. Miscible refrigerants are R600 means butane, R290 means propane. In this case, oil is returned to the compressor along with the refrigerant which boils off in the evaporator. Other properties of refrigerants: odor, means it is unpleasant smell of the refrigerant. Freons are odorless. Ammonia has odor which spoil the refrigerated product when come in contact. Hence, ammonia refrigerant is not referred in case of domestic refrigeration applications. Leak tendency of the refrigerant. It should be low in order to reduce the cost of refilling of refrigerant to the system. Ammonia leakage can be detected easily by its pungent odor. Fluorocarbons are odorless because hence it is difficult to detect the leakage from the system. Cost of ammonia is low, so it is cheapest and available. R600 is expensive refrigerant. So, now we will see desirable properties of secondary refrigerant, which are: secondary refrigerant should be having high specific heat. It should be with low viscosity. It should be non-corrosive. It should be inexpensive. it should be chemical stable and it should have good heat transfer property. Secondary refrigerants are ethylene glycol, brine solutions used. So at the end of this session, you can explain desirable properties of primary refrigerant and secondary refrigerant. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.